reporting on the games you love by people who love to game. The MMO Reporter Network. You're listening to Guild Wars Reporter on the MMO Reporter Network. Brought to you by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download at audibletrial.com/MMOReporter. And by Doghouse Systems. Choose your weapon at doghousesystems.com.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Guild Wars Reporter. This is episode 109. I am Celeste, and as always, I'm joined by the lovely Allona.
Hello, Celeste.
Hello. How are you?
We're good. Apparently, I'm wee now. We're good.
I'm frazzled, but I'm doing well. It's been an exercise in technical failures tonight,
or successes because we're at least on the air.
This is true. This is true. Yeah, I mean, it depends on which way you want to look at it. That's for sure. Allona.
Yes.
What did you do in game this week? Or 2 weeks?
It's 2 weeks. One we kind of did together, so I'll wait until for yours, because mine's longer. I did a Citadel of Flame Path True run with the guild, and I think it was, I can't remember who all was at. It was Hunter, Cal, a few other people, I can't remember. But it was a path that a bunch of us had never done before. In fact, I think Hunter was the only one who had. And it was fun, and it was good for achievement points, so yay! I ran with Wardens of Destiny in Eternal Battlegrounds prior to the end of the spring tournament, and I was useless and confused the whole time.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I did not enjoy myself at all. I mean, they were great. Like, this had nothing to do, like, they were very helpful and supportive, but I was lost. I didn't know what the hell I was doing. I got my little necro chef to 400 finally.
Yay!
Finally. So I'm super happy about that. I cleared out my bank, so I actually have room in my bank vault now.
Oh my god.
You're holding
like 8 tabs.
Yes. I did a good job. One of the things was I had an outfit, like one of the profane armor sets, the skins, just sitting in there. I bought it when it was on sale a ways back, and I thought, well, okay, I finally used it on Allona, so I am like super trampy now. It is awesome.
I like the profane skin. I think it's really cool. Like, well, it's nostalgic. I had that on my necro.
See, I never played a necro in Guild Wars 1. I mean, I really like it, don't get me wrong, but I'm just like, whoa. In fact, Surly in the guild asked me if my mother lets me go out like that. Because she was like, oh, Allona. It was like, that was a thing. But that cleared out 6 spaces. And then I did a bunch of stuff. And then Hunter made fun of me that I should be used as an example for how not to keep your bank organized. Because it was just a thing. I spent a lovely and terrifying evening with Key and Hunter getting the Master Sky Crystals. And it was crazy. It was fun. There was a lot of falling. Hilarity ensued. And for whatever reason, that night, I was getting crazy lag. So it would look like I landed, like even to Key. And I think Hunter noticed it a couple times too. Like I would land and then I'd be gone and falling to my death. So it would look like I had landed and I was safe. And then I'd be way off and falling and dying.
That's wonderful. That's great.
Yes, that happened a lot. But, I mean, it's not with armor repair costs. Well, actually, I don't think the armor got damaged from that. In any event, even if it did, it wasn't a big deal because repairs are free.
Right, yeah.
I got the meta for Festival.
Nice. Yeah.
I did not get the meta for the Spring Tournament. but I did collect a few more of the achievement points once it was done, the one day. But I'm still trying to decide if I want the panda or not. Can't decide.
I don't know if I want it at all. I actually was thinking about maybe I'll just give my favor to Ben because he's wanting to have the panda. Aww. And honestly, I'm just like, meh, I don't really want
I like
anything
it
from the thing. So
well, See, I got the wind Zephyr helmet because I didn't get any of the helmets last time, and then I accidentally bought the lightning one, so then I had to buy the wind one, which then left me with not enough tokens to buy the panda.
Oh, that's great.
But I mean, you can get more of those. That's not a huge deal. Like, I still have the fortune, so.
Yeah. I've been using all my tokens on obsidian shards, which is probably like the least efficient way to get obsidian shards. But I went
Might be
ahead
a good way to
and
use
doing that.
leftover ones. Oh, that's actually how
Oh,
I made
yeah.
lots of. I went through and cleared out all my like multiple stacks of ore and stuff like that, and bought like metric crap ton of those Zephyr supply boxes. Although I have like a year's supply of quartz crystals now, I tell you that. It's like
Oh,
that's a lot.
yeah. I've got a
But
couple stacks now.
I got some pretty decent recipes and some satchel recipes, which I liked, so that was kind of cool. I bought the ancestral outfit like the day it came out, because gosh, it's lovely. And much like the profane armor set is kind of nostalgic to you, this one, because it's somewhat Mesmer, Guild Wars 1
It is,
Mesmer-ish.
it is.
So I'm like, ee! So I quite like it. And I love the fact that there's gender differences between the Azura and Char armors.
Yeah, that's
I know
really
not
great.
everyone is like that, but I like it a lot.
Can we jump back to something real quick? You said you got one of those satchel armor recipes. I got one of those too, and I got two of the same one, and I've run into a peculiar problem. It's for Huntsman and Artificer. That's the same character for me. So I basically have an extra one, because you only need to learn it once per character.
You can sell them, or are they soul bound or account bound?
It's account bound.
Oh, poopy.
I'm just kind of like, oh, well, I wish I had known that. It was one of those little things that I was just like, oh, well, that's really kind of cool, but kind of not. It's the repeat effect of it. I'm sorry, I kind of hijacked you. You go ahead.
No, that's fine. I don't think I've had that happen, actually, where I've had duplicates. I mean, I've accidentally bought duplicates, like the Gift of Blades, twice for like 5 gold, because I'm a star.
Oh.
But in any event, I marathoned jumping puzzles with a bunch of guildies for the, and I got the June monthly done already for that, just, that section.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I think I did like 10 that evening. It was pretty good. One of our guildies, Panther, he is not a jumping puzzle fan, and he even went with us. And he was a trooper. He did really well.
Good.
Yeah. Actually, I thought he did perfectly fine in the JP, so I'm not sure. Not sure why he's unhappy with them, but in any event. And not really related to in-game necessarily, but I wanted to talk about it. I rented through iTunes the documentary I Know That Voice, and it's all about voice acting. And it was really, really interesting because, it's all these voice actors, and they devote a fairly sizable section to games. And there's, but even outside of that, you can see like Fred Tatasciore, or I might be saying his name wrong. There's just like, well, Tara Strong, Debbie Derryberry, I'm forgetting names, but like a ton of the voice actors for the game. And sometimes it really was a case of they talk and you go, okay, that's Queen Jenna, or
Oh, okay.
that's the human player character voice, or so it really was. I know that voice. So it was a really great documentary, guys. If you're at all interested in that sort of thing, you can rent it on iTunes.
Sounds cool.
Yeah.
Last Wednesday, instead of having an episode, we decided to go ahead and stream us doing path three of Arah. And it took us 3 hours.
Yes, it
Yep.
did.
But we finished it.
We
So I
did
guess that's a
finish
good
it.
thing.
Yep, and Hunter was kind of our fearless leader in that, leading
Yes.
all the little childrens around through Arah. Changed my build 3 times, slowing us down. It
Yeah,
was.
I am going to have to say thank you to the person who told me that I needed to change my build to something else, because it's been wonderful.
Mikachu or something, was that
Machiko?
Chico? Yeah, I can't, I didn't take.
But I'm sorry, I don't remember your name, but you're awesome. I really appreciate it. It's been awesome in the boss splits to have a good build that's good at doing
Yeah.
DPS.
Well, and originally it was, I'm going to hijack you briefly. Originally it was a little, I think a lot of it was my fault for not doing very well at the beginning, because I thought I'd try a healing mantra build, and it was not a good idea. It was the opposite of a good idea, so.
We didn't do that badly, honestly. I think it was we'd just get like caught up on one thing, or we'd go off and do something like we'd forget to call targets.
Well, yeah.
Like when there was six or seven different guys in front of us, it's like, okay, who's gonna call it? Then eventually I'd be like, okay, I'm calling a target. And be like 3 seconds before somebody else did, when somebody else realized, oh, we're not focusing on one thing. Oops.
I'm more being just like in the first like even 5, 10 minutes was when I was doing the healing mantra build where we wiped like constantly. Like on trash mobs we were wiping.
Yeah.
That
It
one
was.
that was totally on me, I believe. Like that the build I had was not conducive to that. Oh,
It
Hunter's
was.
good. He said it was fine for a first time group. Actually, Hunter, which one? Oh, the undead chicken.
Yeah.
That was fun. The ending was worth it, actually.
Yeah, the ending was fun. It was a lot of work. It was one of those things where 3 hours in, I was just like, huh, can we finish already? It was an adventure to be sure, and I think we'll probably do that a couple more times during the summer when I need a break.
I
But
enjoyed
we
that,
do.
just streaming the gameplay.
Yeah.
So, would you say the most challenging part, though, was the relaying the orbs?
You know, I didn't feel like it was really that challenging. It just took us a long time to figure out how to do it properly.
Yeah, no, I don't mean challenging as frustrating, just really working out the coordination. And even if you did it, sometimes it didn't take.
Register properly. Yeah.
Yeah, or something. But it
Yeah.
was, I just wanted to call that out because I thought it was challenging, but I enjoyed that mechanic, like that they added not fighting constantly. Like it was the puzzle solving.
Yeah, let's go ahead and explain a little bit how it was. You said you had to take this orb from, like, this was like a lantern, and you had to run it down this hallway, except you could only carry it for a certain amount of time before you would die. So it was like a relay race where one person would run it to the next person, to the next person, to the next person, and then we'd all have to start running to the back so that we would keep going down this long hallway. And it took us probably 30 minutes to realize to try and use portal.
And then, of course, because I'm the one using portal, I would take it, take the portal, and I'd run the opposite direction that I needed to go, and then I'd panic and die.
Which, if I had been the mesmer, I probably would have done as well. So I mean, nobody can fault you for that, seriously.
I was mostly entertained by my, like, really? I'm the worst mesmer ever. It was still fun.
I really enjoyed it. Another thing I did is that I went through and I was playing in the gauntlet and I got up to tier 3, so I got enough
Nice.
achievement points that I got my 7K chest. And from salvaging all the stuff from boss splits, I've gotten up to 90% magic bind.
Fantastic.
Yeah. As far as the gauntlet goes, I can't seem to beat Subject 7. I've gone through Dolphy's guides and stuff like that, and it's just kind of like, meh, not really working out for me at the moment, but gonna try. I also picked up my gift of battle because I finally got to rank 14 on Robus's World, so that's another part of the legendary taken care of finally.
Yay! How much closer are you? What's the percentage are you at?
Oh gosh, I think I'm probably like maybe 20%. See, it's hard to tell because I've got the big part. I've got the precursor, you know?
Yeah.
With all the other materials, it takes time.
Saint in chat room just called me the moon moon of mesmers.
Wow.
I'm more entertained than offended. Damn
The
moon.
last thing I did is after the little patch that we had yesterday, I decided to go ahead and key farm, and I farmed up 3 keys and opened up 3 chests and was not happy with anything that I got, but
Oh.
I did it.
But did you get any mystery tonics?
No.
See, that alone makes me happy, right there. Gotta
I've
say.
only ever gotten like 20 of those, so.
Ugh, I was getting them every single, like it would be a speed boost, an XP boost, and like 3 mystery tonics. Like, I don't like you, mystery tonic.
Instead of mystery tonics, you'll get those powders. Because that's exactly what I got. A speed boost, an XP boost, powders, and then the bonus powder. Oh, and I got a metabolic primer.
That's not too
which I'm
bad.
thinking is now like not my most favorite thing to get now that I actually think about it. I remember when it first came out, I thought, well, that's kind of cool. I could
What
see
does
how
it
that
do
could
again?
be useful. You double click it and then you double click the food that you want to
Oh,
have and
that's
it'll
right.
last for like 12 hours, I think is what it said.
That would have been handy, though, for Arah.
For our 3-hour dungeon. Yeah, it probably would have been handy there.
I'm going to remember that next time that we run Arah.
So I guess if I'm gonna be like doing 5 or 6 dungeons in a row, I'll use my primer. You just gotta remind me, okay?
And it's only for food, not
Yes.
for potions or tonics or what have you.
Just foods.
So we are actually pretty busy.
Well, it's been 2 weeks, so yeah, we've been busy. So let's go ahead and remind everybody that we live stream Wednesdays at 9:30 p.m. EST, 6:30 p.m. PST, as long as we
Right
don't have
here.
technical problems.
Yes.
Right here at twitch.tv/MMOReporter. You can subscribe to the audio version of the podcast on iTunes and remember to rate and review us over there at Guild Wars Reporter.
Yes.
Report from Lion's Arch.
So the big announcement that happened while we were gone
A day
is
before we
that,
decided to stream.
yes, the season 2 of The Living World has been announced to be happening on July 1st.
Yay! With a lovely little teaser image.
Yes, which I think is awesome.
Yeah. And they also pointed out in that post that the Festival of the Four Winds is going to continue until that date, which, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you for giving us an actual end date. Because there's always the, like, oh, do I have to rush through this? Am I going to have time to finish this? Because you never know when it's going to go away.
Exactly. And it's made me feel a lot more relaxed about getting things done. I don't feel myself
Stressing.
Yes. Even though I know that I have a lot of work to do still, it's like, I don't have to worry about it right now.
Well, like, I haven't been in the gauntlet at all yet, but I have the festival done. So I'm like, okay, well, I know I can go in for, you know, an hour or so and do that if I wanted, or still try for boss blitz and gold, or, you know, any of those things. Like, I have time. I've been given the gift of time.
Which is an amazing thing. One of the most awesome things that happened is over on Under the Pale Tree, Dak decided to tear apart where this portal from the teaser image might be located at.
Yes.
I love this because he kind of broke down, okay, where would we be going if something like this were happening now versus the 250 years ago and how you would get down to, well, I mean, what is essentially the dry top, because it seems as though that's where we're going.
Yep.
I love the fact that he, before he kind of spoiled himself, he went and looked at all these different corners trying to find an area for where it could be at, and it was just really interesting to see him pull it together.
Like match kind of the landscape in areas to what we saw as far as lighting and type of plant life in the teaser
exactly.
image. And he annotated it very well.
Absolutely. It's a great job. But now that there's been a patch yesterday on the 3rd, it seems as though there's a new path that's been added on the map right outside of Toxel Bog, and that goes straight into the circular area that is Dry Top. So it's pretty obvious that that's the exit we're going to be taking.
Although that Dry Top looks a lot bigger than the Dry Top from Guild Wars 1 if you match maps to maps. But actually, before the show, I went in to Brisbane specifically to see if I could get to that area, and I couldn't. It did show up as unfogged, but I can't get to it. Just FYI.
Well, you know, there's usually a pretty big space in between the portals, so.
Yeah, so I just, because I was like, I wonder, can it, and the thing is, where I think it is, I was trying to decide if you had one of those either jump shot or experimental rifles, if you could get to
the other side to break it.
Yeah, because, you know, it's one of those ones where you come out of that area where you're fighting the white mantle ghosts. Slips down really suddenly, and so you'd fall. But if you kind of get as close as you can and kind of kitty corner to you, there is on the same level, another plateau, and it's not super duper far away. So I'm thinking that you could probably launch over there with the experimental rifle, which I don't have, but
right,
I was curious.
Yeah,
but... I was curious. So.
Well, that's cool.
But yeah, Dak did a great job on that post.
Yeah, I really enjoyed looking at it before the update as well. Although I'm really glad that he decided to go ahead and check it out after the patch, because I totally wouldn't have noticed.
You know, they've been doing... Actually, I want to save this part for the end of the next section, which is there was a minor patch on June 3rd, mm-hmm. which had... It was actually fairly major, actually. Like, it was called a minor patch, I think, but there was a fair bit to it. Mostly just tweaks and fixes. We will go through those now. They mm-hmm. removed some lifetime PvP achievements from the nearly completed list so that other achievements can appear in the rotation. And yay! Like, I don't have any of those, but it's nice that they're giving people that opportunity to be able to see other things as opposed to the same things every time. Diving goggles.
It would be nice if you could, like, if you know that there's some that you are just never going to get, like, for me, the diving goggles, if I could just hide it, that would be awesome. Yeah. So I could see, you know, what else I'm close on without having to go through every single menu. That'd be really great.
Yeah. For the gauntlet, Liadri will generate health during the first phase of the encounter. I've never fought Liadri, so this is just a more update for me.
Yeah, but it's one of those, it's like, oh, well, I guess they're making it kind of harder because if she's got a regen now.
Mm-hmm. Boom Boom Bane's healing turret will no longer spawn once the bronze tier of the boss blitz has been reached, and the champions in the boss blitz have grown wary of fighting players for extended durations. Once the bronze tier of the boss blitz has been achieved, they will begin taking increased damage and deal reduced damage. And I'm like, oh, okay, so those last two points, I think, were great updates for these events because there really is no point to further punish players in instances that, for whatever reason, we're not able to achieve gold or silver.
Right.
So it's just like, get it over with. You got bronze. Be happy with what you got. Move on. Abandon the instance and try somewhere else.
I could not agree more with this. It's just kind of like, why would you make it even harder for people that have already, you know, been working at it for such a long time? There's no point in making it even more difficult.
Yeah, like actually, I did a boss blitz and we ended up only getting bronze on it, but there were no commanders. And it was really interesting. Like even with the bronze, only bronze, everyone was really talking a lot in map chat and trying to communicate and trying to coordinate. We just didn't have enough people. Like there were mm-hmm. two bosses that didn't have anyone at all. And so it ended up being tough. So like in that case, like that would be a case where the bronze tier with this implemented would have been nicer. We knew we were getting bronze and we just had to mm-hmm. like at this point, well, let's just finish it. It was really good because everyone congratulated everyone else. Like, well, okay, there were a couple people who didn't, but most people were like, you know, we did really good considering there were no truly organized commanders or guilds organizing this instance. So
right.
Yay. Love that.
No, yeah. As far as boss blitz goes, it's really kind of bizarre how few people you actually need to get it done.
Mm-hmm.
There was one instance where I'd gone through and I was sitting through when we did probably 6 or 7 gold runs and then I had to go do some errands or something. But we had 6 people on Karai, the centaur. That's it.
Yeah, it doesn't take long.
We were usually the first one that would get everybody down to like 2 or 4% of health. And then we'd be like, hold and ready. And we'd just sit there and wait for everybody else to get down. And really, that's the same tactic that they're using on all of these instances. Just everybody gets down at 2% and then mm-hmm. everybody burns.
I was in 2 instances where we were like that and we were on track for gold, but it was either Paroxys or Boom Boom. One of those two, that group would have had just difficulties with it. Like either they didn't have enough people or the turrets or what have you. With Paroxys, it's people fighting from the platform,
mm-hmm.
from the ledge. But in any event, so everyone else is trying to hold off, but there's usually like 1 or 2 people who aren't listening to map chat and they're
right,
going gung-ho. What are you going to do?
It happens.
Yeah, it happens. Yeah. The drop rate for the Chaos of Lyssa has been increased, and I think that's great. Wasn't it something like 1,000,001 chance or something crazy?
Yeah, it was a really low drop rate, and the price on it has subsequently fallen quite a bit, I'm sure. On Tuesday, it was down to like 150 gold.
Oh, really?
Which is much more reasonable than what it had been at.
What was it at?
Gosh, I want to say like 500-ish.
Wow.
I could be wrong. Don't quote me on it.
I'm totally quoting you on that. I'm going onto Twitter right now. No, I'm not. the next one is like just, it's such a lovely quality of life. Radassume, the Azura gate map marker tooltips now list their respective gate destinations. Yay!
Yay!
Because I always choose the wrong ones. I'm like, is this the one that takes us to incubation lab? I don't know. I think it is. I'll go there and see. Nope. No, it's not. It's the other one.
I said on Twitter that I was so happy with the fact that they had added the hover to tell you where they were or where they were going. And I was like, this is totally brand new. And they were like, no, this has been in the games for forever. I'm like, it totally hasn't. I remember complaining about this a lot. So I'm glad that the Radassume finally has it.
Yeah, it would say an Azura gate to faraway destinations or something like that.
Exactly, yeah. And that's all it would say. It's just like, no, just tell me where it goes, please.
Mm-hmm. The favor of the festival description now explains that it can be crafted by combining a favor of the bazaar and a favor of the pavilion. How do you get a favor of the pavilion?
I think either through boss splits or gauntlet.
Okay. I did not know that. I think you want to read the next one.
I giggled quite a bit at it. Due to fierce financial competition, one of the armor and weapons merchants in each staging area has declared bankruptcy and moved on. Their goods have been claimed by the remaining merchants.
I did giggle to that too. I'm like, oh, that was someone having fun with their job.
Yeah, I'm glad that somebody had fun with that.
In World versus World, the player count requirement for breakout events has been lowered from 10 to 5. I'm sure that's important.
I could see how that could change things up a bit. Every time I've been on a map, they've always told me to not do the breakout event. So,
oh, really?
Maybe that's just Henge being funny.
Funny. A funny Henge. Funny.
On the Black Lion trading post, the additional crafting license is now available in the gem store. This license allows players to have up to 3 active craft sessions on all characters on their account for the low price of 800 gems in the upgrades category.
Yeah. This is totally, it's not something I'm interested in, because as of getting the 400 in chef, I am a master crafter. But I could see how newer players who don't have crafting professions maxed out yet could find it useful.
I don't.
You don't? I don't. I disagree care. With you. Oh, you don't care. Okay.
No, what? I don't really care. It's 800 gems. I'm not going to spend $10 on it.
No,
I'm
but
just
I could,
flat out not.
But I could see how someone new to the game might want to be able to do that.
I think somebody new to the game is most likely going to be going on character slots or bank tabs.
Well, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Also in the Black Lion Trading Post, there is a mystical dragon finisher, and it's available in the upgrade category for the gem store of the gem store for 800 gems.
It's cute.
It's amazing. And I was laughing so much on Reddit, the commenters kept commenting about Mushu awaken. It made me laugh because I'm like, oh, it's Mulan.
Yes. Pop it on the ground like daisies.
That's my favorite quote.
I know. That's why I said it.
That and no, it was vile. That's my other favorite quote. Both Mushu. For the next 2 weeks in the Black Lion Trading Post, every Black Lion chest will include an additional reward, boost enchantment powder.
Yes.
Yes. It's 1 armor, strength, speed, or rejuvenation booster can be converted to an enchanted combat booster. This booster allows the player to choose from an armor, strength, speed, or rejuvenation buff. And also 1 experience gathering crafting or magic find booster or 2 karma boosters can be converted to an enchanted reward booster. This booster allows the player to choose from an experience gathering crafting magic find or karma buff. I haven't looked at this yet, so these are just words strung together that will make more sense once I actually get in and try them.
Yeah, I haven't played with them yet, so I don't really know, but it sounds cool.
Yeah. Well, and to be honest, I have a lot of boosters.
I do too.
Being able to convert them into possibly something else, I find that intriguing. It's kind of what I was asking for with the PvP glory boosters.
It is. I mean, that's basically what you were asking for, but that ship has sailed long ago.
It's sailed, deleted, gone.
Yes. Exactly. Black Lion chests have been rebalanced, given a new icon, and given an entirely new UI to clarify unlocking and rewards. It's really cool looking, actually. I opened a couple of them, and, you know, you pop your key in, you click unlock, and there you go. Although the chests now, they look like they're unlocked, so you double click it, and it's like, no, you still need a key, buddy.
Yeah. Now, does it do the thing where it just takes you to the store where you buy them? It used to do that with the locked chests.
No, it'll open up the little UI, and then the slot for keys will be gray and red, saying that you need a key to open it.
I wonder if that means if you like put a stack of five keys in there, if you would like unlock five chests at once.
Well, I mean, not at once. You have to click unlock for each time, but
Oh.
it's a lot faster than popping keys a billion times, sort of thing. So it's a little bit less of a hassle, and it does let you see a lot easier what you're getting.
Okay.
I mean, that's a plus.
Oh, and M is for awesome is saying there is a special button that says go look for one at the trading post. So it does kind of direct you towards them.
Ah, okay. For 2 weeks, every chest includes an additional guaranteed boost enchantment powder. New additions to the chest include the boost enchantment powder, times 4, which are rated to be uncommon, custom arena time token times 5, which is considered to be rare, or a royal terrace pass, the 2 week variety, and it's supposed to be uncommon during the Festival of Four Winds.
Yay. There's also a scroll of knowledge and tome of knowledge drops have been slightly increased, and mystery tonic drops have been greatly reduced. Greatly. I'm hoping that means
Yes.
zero. I'm hoping greatly really reduced means zero.
Yeah, with how little people actually costume brawl now, it's just kind of like,
Well, and the thing is, even if they do, they have, there's the toys, there's the endless tonics,
There's a lot going on there.
there's the 800 million mystery tonics you currently already have.
Yeah.
It's a thing. The mini 3-pack set 2 drops have been replaced with a mini 3-pack set 3 drops for this is all specifically Snow Black Lion chests. So that's good. I actually didn't realize they had been still dropping set 2s.
I had no idea. Shows how often I get minis from chests.
Apparently Curious Char is telling me mystery tonics allow you to make Scrit tonics. Please tell me. I did not know about that because I would that's what I'm doing with mine then. So they also in this mini, well, minor patch, fixed a bug that prevented players from hearing other guardians' shouts.
Yeah. Can we just like turn this off? Please. I just want to turn off all the shouting. It gets tiresome. Not from me, from other players.
Always like it when, is it human dudes, when they say like, oh, feels nice, whatever it is. I always just love that one. So anyway, I thought your reaction to that was funny. And then the bit that confuses both Celeste and I.
Yes.
The listing fee can no longer be avoided by listing an item at a lower price than the highest buy order. Items priced lower than an existing highest buy order will now be sold at the lower price. The player with the highest buy order will receive the item and be refunded any difference in price. Let's add an extra buy order in there. I don't know.
Yeah, I somehow this worked out that some people apparently sold precursors for 4 or 5 silver, and I don't know
Oh.
how that happened, but yeah.
They were unjazzed.
Guess it had something to do with the way that the buy orders were working again. I don't know. I read it so many times. I asked Ben to explain it to me too, and I was just kind of like, I don't get it.
I read it too, and I'm like, once again, I understand all these words individually. The combination is
Yes.
confusing me.
Yeah. I'm sorry, guys. If I actually understood what was happening, I would explain it better, but it's already kind of been fixed as far as the precursor thing goes, apparently. I don't know.
Yeah. There was an unlisted change. There's been a few, but one specifically is that dead people in World versus World are now grayed out instead of still showing red on their names or presumably whatever color they're representing. And I could see that being really good. It was one of those, huh, I never really thought about it. But that would be really good because sometimes, for whatever reason, you still think you're surrounded by tons of enemies and they're all dead. So you're not really.
Yeah, because you'll see all of their names on the ground, and you'll be like, oh, there's so many people here still, oh my gosh.
That is
And then you go,
exactly
oh.
what I do. That is exactly what I say.
That's pretty close to what I say, except it's a lot more profanities. Yeah, that's really great. I'm glad to see this in action. It's good. And there's, like you wrote in here, a bunch of profession fixes. That's right, a bunch.
I was like, oh, no, we're not going over all these. But in the patch notes, feel free to look up your favorite profession and see what has been updated.
Yes. Because we're kind of too lazy, I guess is a word you could use, to go over it in depth for every single profession.
There's other videos that will other people cover that.
Exactly.
This is
Just
what Reddit's for.
yes, that's what Reddit is for.
Or the official forums.
Yeah, kind of, sort of.
The profession specific
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
ones.
So unmassively, Anatoly Ingram decided to decide whether or not Guild Wars 2 is actually rewarding. And I summed this up as best as I could by saying it's an article where Massively basically says the only way to make money is to run dungeons, and that the only currency you really need is gold. To quote, he says, "Gold is like air. You need it, it's everywhere, and it only calls attention to itself when you're not getting enough of it." Which,
Yeah.
yes, absolutely, that is what happens. Yeah,
Well,
that.
I really like that was a good statement because I was listening to it was Visual Wood and Matt was talking about something. You're like, well, I'll make 10 gold in a day. And I'm like, well, that's nice
How?
for you.
Yeah.
I don't make 10 gold in a day, but in any event, I was like, so that what Anatoly said is it strikes home.
Absolutely, because I will be lucky if I make 10 gold in a month.
Oh, yeah, I agree. Absolutely. And then you're usually spending it almost as fast as you can get it, so.
Now that I'm doing legendary, yes, that is pretty much the truth. Before then, not so much. He goes on to say, it seems as though it should mean being able to pick what sort of gameplay you'd like to do rather than being required to pursue a specific activity for the whatevers you want. Instead, it ends up placing the highest play value on pure efficiency, and paradoxically, Guild Wars 2 most efficient farming methods tend to be the most boring. It really draws attention to the fact that if you want to have a lot of money in Guild Wars 2, there is a lot of grind to be had.
It's not efficient, I admit that. But I'd rather just run around with guildies and just
Have fun.
talk and have fun. And it's like we're not even doing events necessarily, or it's more maybe map completion for alts or something. So, I mean, it's totally my own fault. I could make more money if I wanted to, but I'd rather have that time with my friends. I
Yeah.
guess. He said jokes about difficult content yielding two blues and a green may not accurately reflect the quality of rewards anymore, but even with a rare or two thrown in, it's still just another glob of ectoplasm or a handful of silver from the trading post. That's, yeah, but ectos, man.
Ectos are awesome, but
Yes.
also just not as awesome as they were previously.
Really?
The price has gone down as far as I can tell.
Oh, that's good for me.
No, I mean, like, I remember they were very expensive in the
Like
first,
Guild
like,
Wars
six
1
months of the game,
expensive?
so.
Because
I don't know, we don't have platinum.
well, that's true. But they were crazy expensive in Guild Wars 1. He finished his, well, sort of finishes. My greatest wish for Guild Wars 2's gem store is that ArenaNet might branch out and offer some really special things, the sort of options players can rarely earn through gameplay, even in the most subscription-based games. More emotes, a greater range of combat voices, wildly different character customization details and unique animations. And I know, well, Em in the chat room, I know for a fact she's mentioned at least two of those things that she would love to be able, like she would say, I would pay for those in the gem store. And I've heard other people say that too. So that those would be really interesting additions to the gem store.
Definitely.
Brain, not brawn, will change the world.
Ask an Asura.
We have an Ask an Asura question, and it came through Twitter of all places.
The Twitters.
The Twitters. Debonair181 had just tweeted at Guild Wars Reporter or Celeste or myself, I can't remember who exactly, but said, you guys should do a podcast for beginners or at least a section on in the podcast dedicated to that. And I know that I've heard that from a few people, to be perfectly honest, that that would be helpful. And so I thought this is a great question for Ask an Asura. It is really difficult to answer briefly.
Yes.
my somewhat cheesy answer initially is I would love our listeners to help crowdsource this topic. I am using social media speak here, crowdsource this topic, and you know, give us a hand by posting some answers, tips, or tricks to either our YouTube channel or the Guild Wars Reporter website, or even through Twitter. That's totally cool too.
Mm-hmm.
So anything that, if you can recall, like something that would have been handy to you, or if you've been running with someone who's new and something that's come up that you think might be useful for people to know who are new players, that would be great. One thing I could think of off the top of my head, and I think most people start taking it for granted and maybe don't let other players know who are new generally, unless they get in a good guild, because I think most guildies are pretty good at telling people, but is to use the Heart of the Mists as a way to ease waypoint costs. And so for new players, Heart of the Mists is the PvP locker. So don't panic about having to go into a PvP locker. You're not going to get jumped as soon as you go in, or lobby, sorry, not locker. So if you're out and about in the world and want to head back to Lion's Arch instead of waypointing directly there, which can get pricey, and if you don't mind loading screens, you'll click on the cross swords in the very top menu on the left-hand side of the screen. And if it's the first time you've been there, you will be put through a brief tutorial. You might be able to skip it, I can't remember. But every time after that, on I think every other character, so I think it's just once this will happen, you can just run straight through to the portal to LA. It's just a nice leapfrog to avoid waypoint costs.
Yes, mainly because you can get to everywhere from LA, so it's really handy to do that. Let's go ahead and say that if you want to share your tip on Twitter, go ahead and use the hashtag GW2TIP tip.
Yep.
So that everybody can see it there easily.
Orlin actually mentioned that typing /wiki in the chat brings up the wiki page. Actually, I did not know that. So, awesome.
Yes, another great thing to know about. And my response to this was, oh, I'd love to add a thing to it, but I totally forgot that this was a thing. My one tip for this week is to buy 12 slot bags rather than 15, 18, or 20, because you can get a whole lot more of them for your money, and it's a lot easier to go ahead and kit out your character the first time around if you're not spending as much money getting the worst bags.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're a lot more economical.
Yep.
We're going to try to include tips in Ask an Azura every week now.
Yes, every week we'll go ahead and add two beginner tips, yours and mine, and take it from there.
Cool.
Tales of Tyria.
So for this week's Tales of Tyria, we have an awesome stop-motion video by Counter656 showcasing an MK2 Gundam, Alphonse Elric of Fullmetal Alchemist, and Saber from Fate Stay Night versus Ritlock Brimstone.
Thank you.
just so cute and awesome.
It really was. And the first thing I thought was, like, did Ritlock use Flame Legion magic?
Yeah, I hadn't noticed that. And then I watched it again. And I was like, oh, yeah. That's odd. That's really kind of strange.
I mean, I like that they had the flamey sword and everything. So I was like, wait a minute. But yeah, that was awesome. Like, so much work went into that.
Another thing that was interesting is that Saber from Fate's Day decided to go for his groin area every single time. Like, why? Just why? I'm starting to wonder if maybe it was just the height difference a little bit, but it was just kind of, that's odd.
Yeah, that's because I thought it was funny, like, right at an area where, you know, there's a lot of nice veins in the legs right there, and he's going for the armored area.
Exactly.
Not that I think about those things regularly or anything, you know, like the best places to stab people. I totally don't think about that often.
Yeah, me neither.
No.
It's really cool looking. Pretty hefty. And to be continued, I'm curious to see what it'll be.
Mm-hmm. And we had a Croyve on Tumblr posted a telejoke, and the person was asked to tell a joke about Guild Wars 2. And they said, a char walks into a bar. I presume you're showing it.
I am.
And I thought that was cute. It's like, it's a well-drawn char walking into a bar.
To a bar. It hurt a lot. The end. That's just how it goes.
Yep.
It's just funny. Silly. It is. Funny.
It's silly and funny.
So over on Tumblr, Kobold Art decided to share a sketch of an Azura hugging a panda. And it's adorable.
It is really cute. It's like, that Azura feels 6 feet tall.
I really, really would like it if it wasn't just minis. If I could get a panda pet, that'd be pretty awesome.
Maybe you can.
In Kantha.
At some point.
In Kantha.
Yeah. Okay. This isn't necessarily the place or time for this, but I think we're going to go to Allona before we go to Kantha.
I hate you.
There's already a gate right there.
I know. It just makes me sad.
Not me, but it would... I'm torn because I think there'd be rioting if they did, but that's what I want. And they kind of built it that would be where they'd go. But anyway, that's neither here nor there and not part of the show. That was just me segueing.
I understand.
So in the show notes, chat room and listeners, I posted... sometimes Celeste and I will post stuff for each other that aren't meant for the show. And I posted one. And I said, not for the show, but... And Citri Plays Tumblr posted this. Are you showing it now?
Yes.
And Celeste types in bold italics with underlines, yes, for the show.
Yes, for the show. Because definitely.
I thought it was... Your reaction made my night. I thought that was hilarious.
It's a cap of one of the updates. It says, the additional crafting license is now available in the gem store. This license allows players to have up to 3 active crafting professions and all characters on their account for the low price of 800 gems. Low price.
Smile.
Smile. $10.
I saw that and I just giggled, so I had to share it with you.
If you have a community event that you would like for us to share, please let us know. Likewise, if you've got a burning question for our Ask an Azuran segment, we would love to be able to help you out.
Although now we have, like, kind of guaranteed Ask an Azura content now, thanks to Debonair181.
I suppose guaranteed in the sense that, yes, we will be doing it.
There's always tips.
Go ahead and talk about our sponsor. Our first sponsor is Doghouse Systems. If you use the coupon code MMORreporter at doghousesystems.com, you can double your RAM on a new PC or laptop of your choice for free.
Or if you go to audibletrial.com/MMORreporter, you can get a free audiobook of your choice, which you get to keep for evers.
For evers. Five evers.
For five evers.
Yes.
Six evers.
Infinity evers.
Damn, can't top that.
I win.
You do win.
So, Allona, if people want to get in contact with us, what are some of the many ways that they could do so?
They can email us at gwreporter@mmoreporter.com, Twitter at gwreporter. Our website is guildwarsreporter.com. Voicemail is 616-666-6778. Or use the widget on the right-hand side of the website. Our YouTube channel is MMO Reporter Network. Remember to like our videos and subscribe to the GW Reporter playlist within that channel. Facebook is GW Reporter. We have a Tumblr, gwreporter.tumblr.com. We made good use of Tumblr today for our Tales of Terraria.
We did indeed.
Yes. And you can visit us individually on Twitter. Celeste is at Celeuki, and I am at One Big Pear.
Oh, I thought we were doing like a reversal thing where I was going to say your Twitter handle and we could get people confused about which one of us was Switch again. So I thought that would be funny.
We should do that. We should do that sometime. Just do an entire show where we called each other by the wrong
other person.
Name.
Yeah, that would be excellent. We can do that for April 1st.
I was just gonna say, but now we've outed ourselves.
People will forget by now.
Okay. Also, I just want to call back to something Orlin wrote much higher up that I just read. It was about the Ritlock video, that Ritlock must have slept with one of her friends, about how she was stabbing at the groinal region the entire time.
That's the problem.
Yeah.
Okay. So thank you to our chat room for sticking around. We really appreciate it. And thank you, Allona, for coming doing yet another show with me. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Thanks for calling me on Skype almost every week.
It's every week. Yeah. 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 And thank you for downloading the podcast. We hope that you download it again next week. But most importantly, we hope to see you in game.
Shadow from a pair of demon's wings, but none here fear the future or the darkness that it brings. The monster puts on quite a show, expecting us to yield, but there's just one course of action when we take up sword and shield. Smash the dragon, drive it right back into its den. Smash the dragon, may it never rise up again. Send our best and bravest to attack with all their might. The skillful and the willful each line up to join the fight. The beast may lead corruption in a swamp across the land, but we won't leave it breathing when our heroes make a stand. Smash the dragon, drive it right back into its den. Smash the dragon, may it never rise up again. In dozens from the peaks and from the shore, but we face each wave with bravery and we'll never lose this war. In every brawl a few may fall, but more will join the queue, and if